How does tinnitus impact on sleep?
Well, there's a very, it's a hugely interesting subject that concerns an awful lot of people. Sleep disturbance is either the most common or the second most common complaint that people coming to a tinnitus clinic have. So it affects vast numbers of people. So people are saying that they don't sleep so well since they've had tinnitus, that they can't get off to sleep, or they wake up too soon, or they wake in the middle of the night, or they wake at the end of the night. So that link is there. But one of the things that I find really interesting about it is that not everybody with tinnitus complains of this. For some people, going to bed and going to sleep is a blessed relief. It's the one time that they get away from their tinnitus. So that fact means that we have to question the link between tinnitus and sleep very carefully, particularly when we come to the idea that maybe tinnitus is causing the lack of sleep or the interference with sleep. Now, we don't know precisely what proportion of people who are coming to a tinnitus clinic suffer from bad sleep, but our estimate within our clinic is that it's about 50% of people. Other estimates, I must say, are higher than that. They may be 60 or even 70%, but they're guesses. But not everybody is affected. So that may mean that it's not the tinnitus itself that's causing the interference with sleep. It may be the worry associated with tinnitus, or the focus of attention upon it, rather than simply the existence of tinnitus or not. Now, when I talk to my tinnitus patients about their sleep, I ask them, what time do you go to bed, and what do? Do you read, and what time do you turn the light out, and how long does it take you to fall asleep? And I take a kind of careful walk through their sleep routine and the times that it takes them to fall asleep and when they wake up. And I notice that as often as not, people wake up after a period of time that more or less matches the time when the body wakes up anyway. So a really important point to know and to understand is that normal sleep involves not simply 8 hours of oblivion, but rather it's a very active process in which we go through different stages of sleep, from light sleep into deep sleep and back up into light sleep again, and into dream sleep or rapid eye movement sleep, REM sleep as it's called. And within that up and down throughout the night, there are periods of awakening. Now, this happens to everybody. For a lot of people, they wake up, they turn over, they go back to sleep, they probably don't even remember that they'd woken up. But nonetheless, this happens. I think when people wake up and the first thing they hear or the first thing they're aware of is their tinnitus, then maybe they don't turn over and go back to sleep quite so quickly. But then they're waking up as part of a normal sleep-wake cycle. And it's not tinnitus that's waking them up. And I think that's an important thing to understand. I think if you fear that tinnitus is powerful enough to rouse you from your sleep, then you've got a real monster on your hands. And actually, as much as we know at this time, is that that's not what happens. One other point I think to make is that as the night progresses, the stages of sleep change. So we tend to drop into a deep sleep near the beginning of the night, near the beginning of our sleep time. And in the second half of the night, our sleep tends to be light. We tend to have, of the four stages of sleep, 1, 2, 3, and 4, we tend to sleep in the second half of the night, mainly in stage 2 sleep, or in this REM sleep, this dream sleep. And even in stage 2 sleep, we can go on thinking about things, we can go on mulling troubles over. It's that kind of grey area when you're not quite sure if you're awake or asleep. And much of the second half of the night is made up of that in normal sleep. So when people are complaining of very light and perhaps fragmented or broken sleep, sometimes they're getting a normal sleep that they're now thinking of it differently, and they're thinking perhaps it's not the right sort of sleep. But it is important to understand that sleep is not just about deep sleep. We need this, we seem to need this mix of light and deep sleep.